Hi, Two Bunch Palms. It's Mrs. Macias and Dr. Grafton from DIGICOM Club. We'd like to welcome you to our second annual DIGICOM Film Festival here at Two Bunch Palms.
This year is very special because it is our first ever virtual Two Bunch Palms DIGICOM Film Festival. Since we couldn't celebrate this year with you in person, we thought we would bring the celebration home to you. Now, let's introduce our Two Bunch Palms principals.
Hello, and welcome to the Two Bunch Palms 2020 DIGICOM Festival. This isn't the festival that we have planned, but we are very excited to be able to bring the festival to you virtually and celebrate some of the creative videos that students and staff have created this year.
Thank you to Ms. Macias, Dr. Grafton, the DIGICOM Club, and Alex Cruz from DIGICOM for making this virtual festival possible. Kudos to the DIGICOM Club for meeting virtually during the COVID-19 school closure and even creating some videos from home.
We miss you all, and we are looking forward to the day when we can all be back at school together.
This place is too quiet without all of our jackrabbits.
Enjoy the show!
Let's get started. Tonight you'll experience a journey of emotion, so sit back and relax. Our first section is dedicated to the students who promote change.
You can be a good friend by giving good compliments.
Hey, Agent, you look good today.
Thanks.
Are you okay?
You can be a good friend by helping someone with their
I wish I could color.
Hey, Agent, you can use some of my pens.
Thanks.
You can be a good friend by sharing.
Can you please pass me a pencil?
Sure.
Thank you.
You can be a good friend by having good manners.
Be a friend!
Since 1972, Guide Dogs of the Desert has made a difference in the lives of individuals who are blind or visually impaired. Guide Dogs of the Desert provides custom-trained guide dogs that provide independence and safe mobility for individuals at no cost. GDD uses standard poodles and Labradors for guide dogs. These puppies are 3 weeks old and will come in for formal training to be a guide around the age of two. If you would like to become a puppy raiser and change the lives of others, please email acoleman@gddca.org.
Did you actually know that today was Read to Me Day?
I didn't know that.
Did you know that today was actually Dr. Seuss's birthday and we're going to celebrate it?
Oh, I didn't know that.
Well, yep, and today I'm going to try to find some people to read to.
Bye, Annabelle.
Hi, can I read you this book?
No, reading is boring. Coloring is better.
Hey, can I read this book to you?
No, it's okay.
No, sorry, TikTok's more important.
Hey, can I read you this book?
No, books are stupid.
Oh, I'm going to give you your first day of work, and I can't be here, but I made a list for you.
It was...
What are you doing?
Playing the toys.
Do you want me to read to you while you're playing with the toys?
Yeah.
They drove away. My, what nice folks. I'm going to like working here. Here I stand just looking at me with a whole list of things to do.
Did you know reading to a child develops empathy? Did you know reading to a child builds language skills? Did you know reading to a child builds positive relationships? Experience the magic. Read to a child.
Congratulate the students for being leaders of change. You did a great job. We also want to thank all the teachers who worked hard on their classroom videos, even the ones who didn't get to finish in lieu of this COVID-19 school closure. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Up next is a video created by our own Two Bunch Palms teachers in their classrooms. It's called What Up, Teach? Enjoy.
Breaking news. Letter U has gone missing.
I got it covered.
Is he an air boy?
We don't see him in America.
He's not in Utah.
He's not underground.
Was he abducted?
I feel ugly, unhappy, unimportant.
But you are the unicorn!
But you are the universe!
You are unique!
We love you!
It's important that you love you.
Every day, we start our morning off with Inner Explorer's mindfulness.
I like starting our day off with mindfulness because it's fun.
I like starting our day with mindfulness because it helps us to learn better.
I like starting our day with mindfulness because it can calm you down.
I like starting our day with mindfulness because it helps you to be good.
Each day is a different practice to help students calm their minds and get a nice start to their day. Some of the different practices we have done are controlling their breaths, awareness of their senses, managing their thoughts, gratitude for others, and today's lesson is all about kindness.
And with your hand on your heart, repeating to yourself, I have the power,
I have the power
to make wise choices.
To make wise choices.
Today, we'll explore kindness.
After the session, students are given some time to write in their journals about today's lesson.
Today I will do something kind by saying I like their hair.
Destination Saturn was mainly about a planet in our solar system named Saturn.
One thing I learned was Saturn has many moons. Titan is the biggest moon.
One thing I learned about was Saturn has 8 groups of rings.
One thing I learned was the rings of Saturn are ice.
One thing I learned was Saturn spins very fast.
Another thing I learned was Saturn has more than 18 moons.
Another thing I learned was scientists sent a spacecraft to Saturn.
Another thing I learned was a spacecraft landed on one of Saturn's moons.
The third thing I learned was the storm on Saturn is 8 times bigger than Earth.
Last thing I learned was the storm on Saturn is stronger than any storm on Earth.
The last thing I learned was scientists want to study other planets.
The final thing I learned was scientists wanted to know if there is life on Saturn.
In conclusion, scientists have discovered many important facts about Saturn.
We read Narrative Nonfiction Saving San Francisco Bay by Bon Morin.
Kay Kerr and her friends, Esther and Sylvia, wanted to protect San Francisco Bay, but bulldozers were pushing rocks and soil into the bay. So, Kay and her friends talked to some environmental groups about their worries that animals and plants will be harmed. Then the groups became worried too, but they were busy, so the women decided to save the bay themselves. Kay, Esther, and Sylvia wanted to stop the Berkeley City plan to fill in more of the bay. But they need more people to speak out about filling in the bay. So they sent more letters and got people to join Save the Bay. Then the woman told the city council what the scientists said about how filling in the bay will cause an imbalance in the ecosystem. A lot of people wanted to pass a law to stop people from filling in the bay, but they needed to stop the project that was going to crumble part of a mountain into soil. So they took them to court. An agreement was reached. The project was stopped. Now the people in Save the Bay still work hard today to protect the environment.
On October 9th, 1776, Father Paulu established Mission San Francisco de Assis. It was the 6th mission in California. This mission has the nickname of Mission Dolores because of a nearby creek, Arroyo de Nuestra Señora de los Dolores. The native Californians in Mission San Francisco de Assis were the Ohlone Indians. The livestock consisted of fish, deer, rabbits, and birds. Some of the crops were corn, peas, and beans. The men did very hard work, like build the missions and hunt for food. The women gathered food, weaved baskets, and did pottery. Children's jobs were to help their dads hunt if they were boys, and girls had to help their moms gather food, weave baskets, and do pottery. Natural disasters that affected the mission include several earthquakes, but especially the one in 1906 that destroyed a nearby brick church. One of the most unique characteristics of this mission is that it is the oldest building in San Francisco.
Did you know that the Holocaust was only 86 years ago? You might be thinking, only 86 years ago? That's not long. Why are we even learning about this? But we're learning about it because it was one of the most tragic times in human history.
It occurred during World War II when Hitler was leader of Germany. 6 million Jewish people were murdered by Nazis. Millions of other people that Hitler didn't like were killed as well. This included Polish people, Catholics, Serbs, and handicapped people. It is said that the Nazis murdered as many as 17 million innocent people.
The Holocaust happened because Hitler hated Jewish people and blamed them for Germany losing World War I. He considered Jewish people to be less than human. The Jewish people and many others that Hitler did not like were treated very badly. They were forced to close their businesses and go into hiding. They were forced to wear the Star of David on their clothing so that they could be easily identified. They were sent to concentration camps to do hard labor, and they were often killed at those camps.
Every year on January 27th, we celebrate Holocaust Remembrance Day. It is a day for everyone to remember the millions of people who were killed or whose lives have been changed by an event in history called the Holocaust. On this day, we also remember the millions of people who were killed or have been affected by Nazi persecution and terrible crimes committed during the conflicts in Cambodia, Rwanda, Bosnia, and Darfur.
The science of physics all started with forces. A force isn't something you can touch, it's more of an idea. Pretty simple idea too. A force is just a push or a pull, like a football player kicking a ball. Here's some more cool facts about forces. Understanding forces can answer all sorts of questions, like how a skateboarder does cool tricks, how magnetic chains float, and when a person can accelerate as fast as a sports car. Keep watching for more amazing facts about forces and motion. In a game of tug-of-war, each team tries to yeet the opposing team forward by exerting a more powerful pulling force on the rope. If the force is balanced, nobody moves. If one force is stronger than the other, though, the rope moves. Maglev train moves by the force of magnetism. Magnets under the train and on the track push against each other, making the train hover up to nearly 1/10 mph above the track. The train does not have an engine, but it is pushed forward by another set of magnets and can reach speeds up to 360 mph. Just to turn on a skateboard, the force of friction is helping you. Friction slows down movement when two objects rub against each other. Roller coasters use the force of gravity to make a rip-roaring ride. Gravity pulls all of the objects in the universe together, and it is the reason people and objects don't float off this planet into space. When the roller coaster cars get to the top, gravity pulls them down the track toward the ground, getting faster and faster. You don't need superpowers to go as fast as a sports car. Just go skydiving. The moment you step out of a plane, gravity pulls you down. In only 3 seconds, you pass 62 miles per hour. As you speed up, friction with the air drag gets stronger and stronger until the wind roaring past feels like a hurricane. 10 seconds into the jump, the force of draft balances the pull of gravity and you stop accelerating. You've reached terminal velocity.
Kobe Bryant was born on August 23, 1978. Kobe Bryant was famous for being one of the best basketball players in history of the NBA. He's known for winning 5 NBA championships in the LA Lakers.
Kobe was only 17 years old when he was drafted. He had turned 18 by the time his first NBA season started. He was the NBA slam dunk champion in 1997. He has won 2 Olympic gold medals for basketball, and in 2008 and 2012. Kobe holds a lot of records and is a very inspiring player. On January 26, 2020, he and his 13-year-old daughter Gianna were on their way to a basketball game in a helicopter. Sadly, the helicopter crashed, killing all the passengers. Kobe died at the age of 41. Kobe will always be remembered for a legend of the court and being one of the best basketball players of all.
Baile folclórico is a term for the traditional Mexican dances that emphasize the folk culture of different regions in Mexico. Some of the dances represent the state of Jalisco, Veracruz, Sinaloa, and so on. The dancers wear very colorful, long, and full dresses or skirts during their performances. I wanted to teach students to embrace their culture and their heritage through dance. At the same time, it was a way to promote parent engagement as their culture was celebrated through the dance. I would like the Ballet Folklorico Club to continue to grow in the many years to come. I would like to have the group participate in more events throughout the community. This school year, the Ballet Folklorico was able to perform in our winter festival at Chippewa Palms Elementary. And we were also invited to be part of the Posada Festival at Cabot Yerxa Elementary. In addition to that, the group also took part in the Desert Hot Springs Festival of Lights Parade. And I would like to see our group actively participating next school year as well.
I really enjoyed being in Ballet Folklorico. I met some really nice and amazing people. Also, it was an amazing experience for me, and it was amazing doing dances with the class.
Hi, my name is Juliana Gonzalez, and I am in TBP Ballet Folklorico. I joined Ballet Folklorico to learn about Hispanic culture. What I enjoyed the most about Ballet Folklorico was learning to dance, the different music, making new friends, creating new memories, dressing up in beautiful, colorful skirts, and performing at events. The teachers are always very helpful and supportive. It was a lot of fun.
I would also like to say that I am very proud of the amazing work that the group, mostly composed of girls, did in a very short period of time. The acceptance of the Ballet Folklorico by the students, the families, the school staff made all the hard work really worthwhile. Thank you.
What incredible videos from our TBP teachers and students. Congrats. Up next is our All About Me section. This section is dedicated to our DIGICOM Club students and their I Am poems. So grab your popcorn and settle in.
I am outer space. I wonder how many stars are in my galaxy. I hear rockets blasting through me. I see my planets. I want to protect the planets. I am outer space. I pretend each of my stars form a constellation. I feel infinite. I touch the stars. I worry my stars will burn out. I cry if people don't explore me. I am outer space. I understand I am vast. I say I am spectacular. I dream that my planets will last forever. I try to protect my planets. I hope people will care about me. I am outer space.
I am a tsunami. I understand
I am a series of waves caused by underwater earthquakes, landslides, or volcanic eruptions. I wonder why my first wave is not the strongest. I hear the roaring crash of my waves as they hit land. I see people running to evacuate before my tidal waves strike. I want to cause less destruction to the lands I wash over. I am a tsunami. I pretend I don't make communities and families suffer. I feel bad when I destroy villages and towns near the shore. I touch shallow waters and try to reduce my wave size. I worry about Hawaii because it has the greatest risk for tsunamis. I cry when I trap people and animals in my waves. I am a tsunami. I say about 80% of tsunamis happen within the Pacific Ocean's Ring of Fire. I dream of a day when my waves are calm and not deadly. I try to slow down, but my waves can travel up to 500 miles per hour. I hope I can be less harmful. I am a tsunami.
I wonder why people say the sea turtles, but not me. I hear the wind blowing in my many branches. I see people hiking through the forest and enjoying me. I want people to notice how tall I am. I am a mighty tree. I pretend I will never die. I feel sad when people cut me down or burn me. I touch the ground when my leaves and pine cones fall to the floor. I worry too many trees will be cut down for new buildings. I cry when people carve and graffiti my trunk. I am a mighty tree. I understand I come in many different shapes and sizes. I say provide shade for my many humans, plants, and animals. I dream of a world with forests full of trees. I try to provide oxygen for all my many human and animal friends. I hope many new trees will be planted. I am a mighty tree.
I wonder how many people are on me. I hear people talking in different languages. I see the sun. I want for people to stop polluting me. I am Earth. I pretend that people get along. I feel happy when people pick up trash. I touch land, sea, and air. I worry I will run out of natural resources. I cry when people pollute my air and my oceans. I am Earth. I understand I am very important to people. I say that one day people will be peaceful. I dream that people will save me and stop polluting. I try to stop meteors from entering my atmosphere so people don't get hurt. I hope my friend's sun will not explode, so I and everyone on me will not die. I am Earth.
I am the border wall. I wonder how many families I've separated. I hear the many cries of families. I see sadness in the faces of children looking through me. I want to be destroyed. I am the border wall. I pretend I don't hurt innocent people. I feel people's pain. I touch the hands and feet jumping over me. I worry I cause too much damage. I cry because of the devastation I cause. I am the border wall. I understand people have mixed feelings about me. I say I need to be more welcoming. I dream of a day where all people are united. I try not to be scary. I hope for immigration reform. I am the border wall.
Congrats, DIGICOM Club students. We are so proud of you. And to those fifth graders who are graduating this year, I hope you continue growing in your digital storytelling adventures when you go to middle school. Up next is our We Are Family section. This special section is dedicated to all our Two Bunch Palms families and DIGICOM Club families who came out for DIGICOM Family Night. These families worked on creating short videos about their family vacations, their pets, their family members. So here's to We Are Family.
Hi, my name is Alexander. In my family, I have my mom, my dad, my brother, and my sister. Our parents decided to give us a scavenger hunt to tell us we were going to Disneyland. Our parents took us to both California Adventure and Disneyland. We had so much fun. Then we arrived. The first thing we did was take pictures with Mickey Mouse, then all the other characters. Our first ride was an Incredibles ride. It was so fast, my brother got scared. After that, we went on all the other rides. Then the next day, we went to Disneyland. Our first ride was the log ride, and we got soaked, but the long wait was worth it. We had a blast and ended the night with the castle and fireworks. We can't wait to go back. Thank you for watching.
Hi, my name is Mariano. I have a stepdad. His name is Carlos, and together we have dogs. We have English bulldogs and Frenchies. We love our dogs because they are friendly. The Frenchies are very hyper, especially my favorite Frenchie dog. Her name is Madonna. She is always a challenge because she is hyper, likes to chew on laces, and she likes to run a lot. But overall, she is my favorite dog. In conclusion, I love that me and my stepdad have dogs to play with and to teach them new tricks and feed them. A family with dogs is a happy home.
On Sunday, February 2nd, our family took a trip to the grandmother for cystic. We were able to feed the parakeets and hold them.
We saw a big stingray. We got to see a sea dragon.
We were able to watch a scuba diver feed the fish. We got to see different types of penguins. That's our trip to the aquarium of the Pacific.
Hi, my name is Sebastian.
Hi, my name is Julian.
And this is our family.
This photo represents our trip to SeaWorld
for my birthday.
First, we went to see the flamingos. Then we went to see the seals.
When we were walking, I saw a lot of birds with the seals.
After the seals, we went to the aquarium.
We saw some sharks and other fish that were cool.
After, we went on a ride that was super fun. After the ride, we went to the
orca show that was really fun.
After SeaWorld, we went to a hotel. The next day, we went paddleboarding and went on a cruise.
My favorite part
was the aquarium with all the cool fish.
Hi, my name is Adrius, and these are some of my most memorable fun times with my family and friends.
This picture shows when my soccer team was getting our medal. This was one of the funnest days. We went to the Monster Motocross for my brother's birthday. I love when my grandma takes me and my siblings out places. These pictures show my siblings and me at a car museum and Hot Wheels factory. This was a trip we took to Anaheim for the weekend. We were across the street from Disneyland and it had a water park inside it. It was so much fun. My dad likes to take us to car shows with trucks and lowriders. This is when we went to watch an Angels game and the Angels won.
One of my favorite times was my 10th birthday. It was so much fun celebrating with all of my friends. We were singing and dancing, playing football, and jumping in the jumper.
On Halloween, all of my family dressed up like something scary. It was our first time for all of us dressing up like something scary. This picture shows when we dig chairs in the sand and sat. This is the most memorable moment of my life when one of my favorite rappers pulled me up on stage. And that was Memories with Family and Friends. Thank you for watching my video.
Thank you for watching!
My grandfather, Emilio Jimenez III, was a great man, always active since he was a young boy enjoying baseball and sports. Grandpa was also a man of service, serving our country as a soldier in the Army. I am so proud of his service, but most importantly, I am proud and love my grandpa because of the way he cared about our family. He always told us we meant the world to him. And he showed us love every time we were together. Fun, warm, and caring. Grandpa enjoyed sharing all kinds of activities with us. And he especially liked watching us play sports. Grandpa always had time to play with us to make us feel special. I love you, Grandpa. I will always hold these memories close.
Hi, my name is Yuwam, and I want to share with you my story. We are a family of four, and we came from Puerto Rico before Hurricane Maria hit the island. My aunt is sharing her house with us and her three baby doggies. My dad is still in Puerto Rico. So we decided to put hands on our new life. I came to my new school, Two Bunch Palms. I only spoke Spanish, and my mom was worried. But in no time, I started to pick up the language. My sister, a senior in high school, and my mom in college for the first time. So now, every time I see any of my classmates struggling with English, I help them. The same way as Kiara helped me. I worked very hard in school. I love to jump and dance. also sing. I'm a drama queen. Last October, my aunt gave me a surprise. My daddy came to visit us after 3 years since we moved. I was so happy I got to spend a few days with the whole family. Now I have more strength and power to keep on working hard in school and achieve my goals. Sí se puede. Yes, I can.
A special thanks to those families who joined us during the DIGICOM Family Night. We hope to see you again there next year. Our final section of this evening is called We're All in This Together. This section is dedicated to our community members, families, and staff who are working tirelessly during the coronavirus pandemic. We teachers and TBP staff miss you all dearly. And to the essential workers who are on the front lines daily, we want to send a special shout out to you. Each and every one of us is stronger together during the stay-at-home order. So let's end the night with the We're All in This Together.
To me, happiness is when my mom gets me a Lego set that I've been wanting for a really long time.
To me, happiness is when I still get to see my friends during Zoom meetings.
To me, happiness is spending time with my family and being able to do a lot of activities with them.
To me, happiness is being able to stay with my family during quarantine.
Happiness to me means playing with my friends, Romeo, Chris, and George. Another one is playing with my pets and going outside to walk and being with my family.
To me, happiness means that my family is safe and that nothing bad happens to them. And that I can play with my friends on Roblox, because if you can't see them or hear them, at least I can play with them on games.
For me, happiness is spending time with my family, doing activities, and being with my brothers, playing games with them. So, yeah.
To me, happiness is spending time with my family.
For me, happiness is watching movies with my family, playing games with my family, and yeah.
To me, happiness is having fun with my friends and family.
To me, happiness is hanging out with my family, my friends, playing video games with my friends, my siblings, and my dogs. And
to me, what happened to me and my sister would go back riding in the night.
To me, happiness is having a life.
Something that makes me happy is going camping and hiking. I really miss that, especially now that I can't do that because I'm stuck at home. Those are some of the things that really make me happy, going in nature overall.
To me, happiness is being able to be with my family during quarantine.
To me, happiness is when I see other people happy. For example, when I give them something special and they have a big smile on their face, that's what makes me happy.
Mrs. Bernardo. During quarantine, I love to cook with my kids.
Hey, it's Miss Canterbury. During this shelter-in-place time, George, the class penguin, has joined me in Zoom meetings with my students.
Hi, everybody. I'm just here in quarantine playing with my dogs and smelling the roses.
Hey, this is Miss Barrientos, and during quarantine, I am making a cake.
it's Mrs. Fenton. So during quarantine, one thing that I tried to do that I've never done before is I've been doing finger knitting, and I'm making this blanket.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Dorado, and during quarantine, I am training my new dog, Ghost. Ghost, come here. All right, sit. Good boy.
See, what am I doing? Well, I'm done with the news, so let's see what's on Netflix.
I've been working on my Mary Kay business. I've been making gifts.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Macias.
I'm Samantha.
And during quarantine, we are painting!
This is Mrs. Gerdo.
I'm Yamilet.
And during quarantine, we like to
do TikTok.
Hi, it's Mrs. Geronimo, and these are my daughters, Callie and Madison, and we are working on making student bags during quarantine.
Hi, I am actually here in my very messy garage. I have taken on this project since the school closure, and I really do hope, in addition to all of the hard work, that you also take time to do the things that you enjoy.
Hi, I'm Miss Casey, and this is what I do during quarantine.
I'm hanging out with Opal during quarantine. She's pretty fun to hang out with. She likes to give me kisses.
Hi, it's Miss Aguayo. During quarantine, I'm working out on my stationary bike.
This is Mrs. Daniel. During quarantine, I've been doing a lot of yoga.
Hi, this is Mr. Scudder. During the quarantine, I like to read and watch Netflix and come to work.
Hi, I'm Miss Lupercio, and I have been working on my master's program during quarantine and also painting.
Hi everyone, Mrs. Marez here, and I am in a little piece of heaven when I'm in my sewing room. And here's my latest project I'd like to share with you. It's called A Small World, and this is for my granddaughter, Scarlett.
Hi, I'm Coach Matheny, and I've practiced guitar during quarantine.
Hi, this is Mrs. Lupercio. One of the things I'm doing during quarantine is reading. I enjoy having the time to read.
Miss Moreno here. One thing I'm doing during quarantine is crocheting a hat.
It's Miss Ceballos, and during this time, I do my homework, and I like to play board games.
Hi, everybody. I miss you so much. This is Mrs. Joyce, and this is what I'm doing to keep myself busy right now.
Working out on DIY projects while I'm at home. One of them is framing out this window. Haven't finished yet.
Hi, I'm Miss Adams, and during quarantine, I'm spending more time outside.
Hey, this is Mr. Ewald, and during the quarantine, I have been reading. I've read 6 novels.
Hi, I'm Miss Martin. During quarantine, I've just been playing with my kitties, so I'm doing it right now. And my homework for my master's degree.
Hi, I'm Miss Collier, and during quarantine, I've been raising foster kittens. This is Wanda, Flower, and
Winky. Hey guys, Mrs. Mullen. Over quarantine, I've been doing a few things. Been hanging out with my dog, rereading some of my favorite books, and playing on my Switch, mostly Animal Crossing. I can't wait to see you guys.
Hey everybody, it's Miss Griffiths, just at home in quarantine, taking care of Olivia and Leonidas. We like to go for walks and cook dinner. And of course, I have to change a lot of poopy diapers. I hope you guys are staying safe.
What is an essential worker? An essential worker is someone who is needed to work during this coronavirus pandemic. Healthcare workers, delivery drivers, grocery store employees are working on the front lines daily to help us. While many of us are being told to stay at home, these workers have a responsibility during the outbreak to continue to work, many risking their own health for us. These workers are working tirelessly to help protect us and keep us safe. So help us say thank you to all those brave and hardworking men and women risking their lives to keep us safe and healthy during this time.
Bless your heart, no, I love you for that. Honest and selfless. I don't know if this helps it, but good job. You're doing a good job, a good job. doing a good job. Don't get too down. The world needs you now. Know that you matter, matter, matter. Yeah. You're doing a good job. You're doing a good job. Don't get too down. The world needs you now. Know that you matter, matter, matter. As soon as you walk through that door, everyone needs you again. The world's out of order. It's not a sound when you're not a...
Well, that's it for us tonight. Thank you so much for watching our first ever virtual Two Bunch Palm Film Festival. Stay safe and healthy. We can't wait to see you in the fall.